super satisfied through the weekend. You like 9 to 5, I'm the weekend.
Hi guys, what's up? It's Gracie. I'm absolutely terrible because I woke up. It's like 2 p.m. I wanted to make a quarantine video day in my life because everyone is doing it. It's a Monday, so I have to do some schoolwork today, and I'm like really super behind. So right now, I'm gonna get ready for that, but I'm gonna eat breakfast first. I'm gonna show y'all how I make my coffee because a lot of like my friends wonder how I do it.
So first I put my ice cubes in the cup. And then I leave this coffee in the fridge overnight. And then you pour that in first. It's just plain black coffee that's cold. And then I get my favorite creamer, which is caramel macchiato, and I pour that in. You can do however much you want. And then I add Hershey's caramel syrup. You can add however much you want. I tend to do a lot. And then I have this whipped cream. I put that on top. And then add more caramel.
So I have a waffle, and then I have my coffee. I hope y'all enjoyed the little coffee tutorial. So I'm just gonna drink my coffee now and do my algebra homework. So my day has pretty much been wasted because I started doing my homework at 3 o'clock and now it's 7 and I just now finished and I still don't understand most of it. So that was a waste of a lot of time, but I can't really get mad because I sleep until 2 o'clock.
Wonder how dinosaurs went extinct, because like they're so big. And they're so, like, scary and dangerous. How did they all just go away and die? When they can literally kill anything. And all of them died. How did that happen?
Hello, guys. It is the next day. And I pretty much just did algebra all day yesterday. So I decided I'm going to carry this video on to the next day, so. Hello guys, I'm outside because it's actually like hot out here, so tanning, and I have my coffee and my daily Eggo. I am bored and my dad said I can't jump in the pool because there's a bunch of chemicals in it right now. I honestly just want to go to the beach. I'm back inside. I feel like I will get a little bit more tan. A tan takes a while to like kick in, but I'm going to like rinse off in the shower now because I was lying on the ground and on the trampoline. Why don't you say so? I'm back in my room now. And I cleaned the kitchen, and now I'm about to do schoolwork, and I think I'm gonna put mascara on. I am finally done with my homework. It took me like an hour, and I still didn't study Spanish, but I'm just gonna do that tomorrow. I also watched some YouTube while I did it, because who needs to not be distracted? I don't think I worded that correct. My head. That is quarantine boredom. I'm making chicken nuggets and I don't even like this kind, but I want chicken nuggets, so we're gonna deal with it. Now I'm gonna take my doggy for a walk. Sit. Stop. It is like such a pretty day out here. Ah. Carrying her because she's trying to chase other dogs and she is so heavy. No, you cannot run. Okay, guys, I'm outside now and I'm making up a trick. So I've been struggling with this one trick. So rolls are like these, where they like literally roll over your elbows and arms and everything. I've always been better at three-baton, and I'm gonna try to work on my rolls since I have plenty of time. This is one of my favorite ones. It goes like that and then pops back. And then there's one, I don't know what it's called, but it goes like this. And you have to turn and hold over all your elbows in a circle. And I haven't been able to do it, and I can like almost get it. I don't know why it's such a struggle for me. I give up. I lay in the middle of the road literally all the time, but time to get up and practice more. I'm working on a new routine. Okay, I'm back inside now and I'm so sweaty and tired from practicing. But now I'm back inside and we're about to watch our family devotional on the TV. We back in my room. Bathroom now. And it's time for shower number two because I'm sweaty and disgusting. So I just want to end my video like with a little bit of me talking and rambling. I just want to talk about how my relationship with God has been, like a little update, because I like to do that on my channel. I feel like being in like quarantine and being like locked up in the house, it's been a lot harder to stay closer with the Lord, which is kind of ironic because you would think with all of this free time that you have, you would want to like spend that free time getting closer to God. So Sadie Robertson recently came out with a sermon on YouTube called The Call of God, and basically it was just talking about the different responses of people who like hear the call of God, and I took some notes over it, but there was one that said that I've got this response, and I feel like that's really me, because it says the response where we're following God's plan and we like know and hear what he wants us to do, but then we see a better situation come up and we think it's better for ourselves, and then we get off track when ultimately it's not going to fill us up and make us happy. Then she spoke about this one Greek word. I don't think I'm gonna say it right, so don't make fun of me, but it's called hineni, and it means here I am, God, no limits, no distractions, send me. We're called to step into hineni because if your relationship with God, you're holding back stuff, he can't do the full work that he needs to do in your life, and you won't be able to like fully hear the call of God, or you'll fully hear it but you're gonna ignore it and push it away. I feel like lots of times I hold back and have limits and distractions, and that's why I get so off track with God. Like sometimes I'll feel like I'll be on mountaintop and be on fire for God, and then like the next day I'll be like, what happened? And I'll just be like fully living in sin and not even thinking like about what God would want me to do in the moment. But one thing I just want to like remind everyone is that following God, it's not always going to be easy. It's not always going to be like the most simple path. It's rough and rocky, but it's going to be better than anything the world has to offer you. The last thing I want to look at that was in her sermon is when God calls us to something, it's for his kingdom purpose. It's not for us. We won't always understand why he calls us and asks us to do certain things. It's not going to always make worldly sense because it's heaven's view. I really love that and how it was just worded, because a lot of times what God wants us to do, our hearts just don't want it and we don't want to do it. But then like after we realize, oh, this was so much better for me, you would never go back to the place you were. But once you're in that place, you could never see where God is going to bring you. That's going to be the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Give it a big thumbs up, subscribe down below, follow me on all my other social medias in the description below. I also wanted to say that I have a blog now and I write a lot in it, so I encourage y'all to go read my stuff. Here's the link and I'll put it in the description below.
I hope you have a good rest of your day, night, whatever. See you in the next video.